What's up and welcome to One Take. I'm Gil, and today I want to talk about a movie where every time I read news about it, I have to remind myself that yes, this movie is actually happening, and that's The Matrix 4. Part of the reason that's such a surprise to me is because over the last few years, there have been reports of a Matrix movie in development, but it's always been described not as a sequel or a prequel, but more of a spin-off, a movie that takes place in the Matrix universe. Think of Rogue One in the Star Wars universe, for example, or using The Matrix as an example, The Animatrix, the anime spin-off short films that were released on DVD. But after a few years of a slow drip of rumors and reports, it was finally announced just recently, Matrix 4 is happening. Not only that, but Keanu Reeves and Carrie Ann Moss, two of the main original cast members, are back. Today, we have a little bit more news on The Matrix 4, the first official casting announcement besides Keanu Reeves and Carrie Ann Moss. It looks like Yahya Abdul-Mateen II will be in The Matrix 4 in a role that has not yet been announced. This is an actor whose biggest role is probably as Black Manta, the villain in the movie Aquaman. Now, like I said, it hasn't been announced who he's actually playing, but since the original announcement, there have been rumors that the studio is looking for someone to play a young Morpheus. So, with this casting announcement, people have already started to speculate maybe he's being cast for that role. Now, Justin Kroll, a reporter for Variety, had this to say. So, in regards to who he will be playing, while I was originally told this would be for a young Morpheus, sources close to the project would not confirm, with one adding it would be inaccurate to say that. That said, a couple insiders added that even if he isn't playing a version of Morpheus, there is still a strong possibility he would be playing someone connected to the character, like a son or nephew, but for now, it's unknown. A couple of thoughts on this story. The idea that the studio is looking for someone to play a young Morpheus is a strange idea, especially considering that they brought Carrie Ann Moss back, they brought Keanu Reeves back, so if you're going to bring back Morpheus, why wouldn't you bring back Lawrence Fishburne, the actor who played him originally? Now, people keep specifying they're looking for someone to play a young Morpheus. Now, when you hear that, you immediately think flashback, you think prequel, or you can get real sci-fi and say that the original Matrix movies alluded to the cyclical nature of the Matrix. Maybe we'll see a future iteration of the Matrix where a younger Morpheus exists as a predecessor to the Morpheus we saw in the previous film. Maybe Keanu Reeves and Carrie Ann Moss are reprising their characters not as humans, but as code that has lived on. So they come back at an older age, interacting with a newer, younger version of Morpheus. That could be what's happening. It's not that crazy a theory, but even if that were the case, with de-aging technology through CGI being so common in film now, a couple of examples off the top of my head. Gemini Man with Will Smith, The Irishman with Robert De Niro, Al Pacino, and Joe Pesci, if they really wanted to bring that character back, the character that we know, I can't imagine that they wouldn't go with Lawrence Fishburne, even if they needed to de-age him using special effects. So I think more likely what's happening here is a game of Hollywood internet telephone. I see two possibilities, one of which was alluded to in Justin Kroll's tweet. Maybe the studio is looking for someone to play a younger character connected to Morpheus, a son, a nephew, a relative of some kind. That's a possibility, and maybe the story just got twisted and people just took the word young and the word Morpheus and stuck them together. Another possibility is that the name Morpheus will become sort of a code name, and a younger character has adopted the moniker Morpheus. Or it could be a combination of the two. Maybe Morpheus's nephew decides to name himself Morpheus as part of some cause, maybe another human uprising of some sort. Anyway, at this point, there's very little known about The Matrix 4. Really, all we know is who wrote it and that's Lana Wachowski, Alexander Heman, and David Mitchell. We know that Lana Wachowski will be directing, and we know three of the actors who have been cast in this movie. Having said all that, I got to admit, I'm pretty excited for this movie. The Matrix 2 and 3, even though they were disappointing, they hit me at a time in my life where I was just sort of discovering how incredible and original cinema can be. The Matrix 2 and 3 were probably the first time that I lived through the hype of a complete trilogy of films. I couldn't wait for 2 to come out. I remember watching 3 in theaters before I was old enough to know kind of how not great it was. But in the moment, I was so into that movie. I remember my hands shaking during the final showdown between Neo and Agent Smith, even though I barely comprehended what was going on. So a lot of this might be rose-colored glasses and nostalgia, but I'm super excited for The Matrix 4. And if I put all the irrational nostalgia aside, I'm still just very curious to see where they go with this franchise. Because the way The Matrix Revolutions ended, it's very unclear where you would go with a sequel. Especially bringing back Neo and Trinity, assuming that Keanu Reeves and Carrie Ann Moss are reprising their roles. And I'm going to spoil The Matrix now. So if you haven't seen The Matrix, a movie from nearly 20 years ago, you're going to want to shut this off. But it's really interesting to hear they're bringing back these actors whose characters died in the last movie. So I want to say I'm cautiously optimistic, but really I'm psyched. I can't wait to see this movie. And it goes into production next year. The fact that we just got this casting announcement makes me think that there's probably more news on the way. I think it won't be long before we start to learn a little bit more about the plot and hear more casting announcements. And I've got to think it won't be long before we solve this Morpheus mystery. Is Morpheus in the movie? Morpheus Jr. or some other version of that character? Hopefully, we'll find out soon. Anyway, if you enjoyed this video, hit the like button, make sure to subscribe to this channel, and hit the little bell icon so you get notifications whenever we make more videos like this one. Thanks for watching.